Last class we discussed the various topic such as administrative tribunal, NHRC, SHRC, SEBI, TRAI, right? Okay. Today we are going to discuss local self government. Local self government are divided into two. One is the rural local self government. And another one is the urban local self government. The local self government the rural local government deals with panchayat raj system. It is related to 73rd constitutional amendment act 1992, and the urban local government deals with municipality. It is connected with 74th constitutional amendment act 1992. Once again, the rural local self government deals with panchayat raj system. It is related to 73rd constitutional amendment act 1992, and the urban local government deals with municipality. It is connected with 74th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1992. Let us see the evolutions of local self-government. The evolutions of local self-government, the Panchayat Raj system in India. The Balwantrao Mehta Committee submitted in report in November 1957, in which the term democratic decentralization the first appears, and his committee recommends the establishment of the three tier panchayat raj system: gram panchayat at the village level, panchayat samiti at the block level, and jilla parishad at the district level, and the district collector to be the chairman of jilla parishad, and the transfer of resources and powers to these bodies to be ensured. The existence of the National Development Council accept the recommendation, and Rajasthan is the first state to adopt the Panchayat Raj system in 2 October 1959, followed by the Andhra Pradesh in the same year. And next, the Ashok Mehta Committee was constituted by Janata government in 1977 to study the Panchayat Raj institution. This committee made 132 recommendations. The GVK Rao committee appointed in 1985 by the planning commissions in the committee concluded that the development procedure were gradually being taken away from the local self government institution, the resulting in a system the comparable to grass without roots. Therefore, the LM Singhi committee in 1986, and constituted by the Rajiv Gandhi government in 1986 on revitalizations of Panchayat Raj institution for democracy and development. Its important recommendations are the constitution recognition for Panchayat Raj institutions, and the second one, Nyaya Panchayat to be established for cluster of villages. And though the 64th Constitutional Amendment Bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha in 1989 itself, the Rajya Sabha opposed it. It was only during the Narasimha Rao government's term that the idea finally became a reality in the form of 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act 1992. The 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act came into the functions June 1, 1993. The 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act was passed 1992, but it came into functions in June 1, 1993. There are some provisions of Panchayat Raj system. First, we will see the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act. The 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act deals with panchayat raj system and it is also known as the rural local self government, and it include part 9 of the constitutions of India, and it deals with article 243 to 243 o, and the 11th schedule of the constitution of India, and it contains 29 functional items. So these are the very important important things of 74th Constitutional Amendment Act 1992. And the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act deals with municipality. That means the urban local government, it includes part 9A and article 243 P and 243 Z is under the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act, and it deals with 12th schedule and it contains 18 functions. The 74th Constitutional Amendment Act deals with part 9, article 243 to 243 O, and 11th schedule, it contains the 29 functions. And the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act as a part 9A and article 243 P and 243 Z, and it deals with the 12th schedule and it contains the 18 functions. The next we discuss the some provisions. There are the two provisions of 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act. The one is the compulsory provisions, the another one is the voluntary provisions. The compulsory provisions, the compulsory provisions are Gram Sabha, three-tier system, and elections, chairperson, age limit, tenure, and reservations of SC and STs, and reservations for women, and the state election commission. The last one is the state finance commissions. Let's see one by one. The first, Gram Sabha. What does mean Gram Sabha? The Gram Sabha means nothing but in a village there are the many people. So the people cross 18 or who are having the age of 18 simply means that if they are having voting rights, then they will be enrolled automatically in the Gram Sabha. What is the difference between Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat? The Gram Sabha, all the people in a village having their voting rights will form the members of Gram Sabha. You will know Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat is the lower level body, and the Gram Panchayat is executive wing of the Gram Sabha. So the Gram Sabha will elect the executive body, then the body known as a Gram Panchayat. Okay, that body will have the chairperson and members. That is the exact difference between the Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat. And the next one is the three-tier Panchayat Raj system. The three-tier system is district level, block level, and village level. The village level deals with the village panchayat or Gram Sabha, and the block level deals with panchayat samiti, and the district level deals with Jilla Parishad. The next compulsory provisions is the election. The district and block level, the village level election is the direct elections. So these three levels conduct the elections is the direct elections. And next one is the chairperson. The district and block level chairpersons elected indirectly, but the village level chairpersons elected directly. It decides by the state legislature. The next one is the age limit. The persons crossing the 21 or the having the 21, the age limit is the 21. And the next one is the reservations of seats for SCs and STs. The reservations of SC and ST's people, the SC/ST quota have their respective reservations. The local body also have their respective reservations. And the reservations for the next one is the reservations for women. The reservations for women, that is all board, the 1/3 of the seats for women. And the next one is the state election commissions. State election commissions is responsible for the elections in the panchayat level. So the panchayat elections for held by this state election commissions. There are only handling this, the panchayat elections. The next one is the state finance commissions. We all know in a state, the governor will set up for finance commissions every 5 years. That finance commissions will deal with their financial things of panchayat. What is financial things? The financial thing is nothing but the devolutions of rupees from the state. The state will give some rupees to panchayat. So for which panchayat or which body you should have what amount of preposition, that will decide of finance commission and also the money given by state. How the money the panchayat are utilizing and how they are regulating, that all things that taken care by the state finance commissions. The last compulsory functions is the tenure. That is a 5 year. All these local bodies, they will be, they will have the tenure of 5 years. After the end of years, the elections will be happening. The local body elected 5 years is retiring. Before the end of 5 years, the elections will be taken place and the next local body will be coming in place. But in case this local body government got dissolved by the stateless state. Yes, the stateless states can dissolve this local body government. You suspect the happen means in 6 months the election should be take place. The members, any disqualified, they remove. These are the compulsory provisions. The next provisions is the voluntary provisions. The representations of MPs and state legislature at different level falling within their constituency. The seat reservations for backward classes, the BCs. And giving panchayat powers and authority to enable them to function as institutions of self-government. And the powers and representations upon the panchayat to prepare plans for economic development and social justice and also perform the 29 functions as mentioned in 11th schedule of the constitutions of India. The granting financial power to panchayat. Okay, and the second function is to implement the scheme. They implement the scheme, the state government and central government introduce some schemes. For example, Yojana MNRGS, that means Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Grant System, guarantee system. Let us see the state government coming with some pregnancy plan in all the states, in which all pregnant women are giving some additional benefit, that is giving cash transfer to their respective account. The implementations means that work will be done by the panchayat or the respective board will take care of implementing of the scheme. Okay. And the next one is the finance. Finance is that collections of taxes, levy, duties, and the fees face at the respective level. The respective level means panchayat means at the panchayat level. The district means at the district level. The block means at the block level. Although the state government, if the state government collecting the tax this region, the those tax the panchayat level. And the next one is the union territory and scheduled areas. You know that there are the 7 union territory, and we talked about the panchayat raj system in the state. But the applications of panchayat in union territory is desired of the president. Okay, if the president feels that it can be allowed, certain union territory it can allow or it cannot allow, or it can allow with their respective amendments. All it is desired by the president with the respective union territory. What about the scheduled area? The first of all, what is the scheduled area? The scheduled area are areas consisting of people who are not economically represent that and who are backward. The backward only that represent the society. For example, Adivasi groups, the tribes and Andamans or Northeast, these are the scheduled areas. Let us say the 5th schedule and 6th schedule entirely for scheduled area. The both schedule deals with scheduled area except for the 4 state. Like Assam, Tripura, Meghalaya and Manipur. The short form ATM M. A for Assam, T for Tripura, M for Meghalaya and M for Manipur. In 1992, the local body ideas was not extended to this scheduled area. This act was introduced, that means PISA Act. PISA Act in 1996, the PISA Act, that means the Panchayat Extensions of Scheduled Act. The 5th schedule deals with administration and control for all the scheduled areas, all the state except the 4 state. Those are this Panchayat Raj has been extended. 6th schedule not comes under the ambit of the PISA Act. The Assam, Tripura, Meghalaya and Manipur, that area not have this Panchayat system. That is the main concept of PISA Act. And let's move on. The 74th Constitutional Amendment Act, 1992. The 74th Constitutional Amendment Act is also known as the urban local government. That means the municipality. The urban means what and all area will comes under the ambit of the urban. Some conditions that 5,000 people. The more than 75% of men should be employed in non-agriculture, and the density should be 400 per square feet kilometer. And already we discussed the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act 1992. It includes the Part 9A of the Constitution of India, and Part 9A, the Constitution of India, Article 243 P2, 243 Z, and the 11th schedule, it contained the 18 functions items. And the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act deals with history, structure, elections, chairpersons, provisions, types, and planning committee. Okay. The first, we will move on the history. The first municipal corporations was set up 1687 and 1688 Madras, and the 1726 Bombay and Bengal, and the 1989 the Rajiv Gandhi government came into existence. 65th Amendment Bill the 65th amendment bill, which is called the Nagar Balika bill. And what is mean Nagar Balika bill? It is the name to research the municipal commissioner and bodies. This bill got passing the Lok Sabha but got defeated in Rajya Sabha. In 1990, VP Singh government again passed the 65th amendment bill, but the government got it dissolved. Again in 1991, Narasimha Rao government passed the 65th amendment bill, which successfully created 74th Constitutional Amendment Act 1992. The next, the structure of 74th Constitutional Amendment Act. The 74th Constitutional Amendment Act deals with municipality, that means urban local government. It includes Part 9A and Article 24(3)(p) and Article 24(3)(z) is under the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act, and it deals with the 12th schedule and it contains 18 functions. Already we discussed the 74th Constitutional Amendment structure. There are the three structure. What are they? The district level, block level, and the village level. The 74th Constitutional Amendment structure, there are the three structure, such as municipal corporations, municipal council, and Nagar Panchayat. Let's see the municipal corporations. The municipal corporations, for a larger area, the metropolitan area like Chennai, Mumbai, Bangalore. And the municipal council means the small area like within the Chennai, within the Mumbai, and within the Bangalore. And the Nagar Panchayat means the area which is transforming the rural to urban. Okay, the municipal corporation means it's a larger area, the metropolitan area, and municipal council means the smaller area like within the Chennai. And Nagar Panchayat means the area which is transforming to the rural to urban. And the next, move on the election. The 73rd and 74th conduct the direct elections. In 73rd constitutional amendment, the chairperson, and next one is the chairperson. The 73rd constitutional amendment, the chairperson at the district and block level is indirectly elected, and the village chairperson is decided by the state legislature. But here, the urban local institution, all the chairpersons elections for all the local bodies, in three bodies chairperson, it is left to the state legislature. The state legislature can deal with it. The state legislature having the power to administrator. The chairperson elections with the respect to these three bodies, that is the structure of municipal bodies. And the next, move on the provisions. The 73rd Constitution Amendment Act, there are the 10 compulsory provisions in Panchayat system. And the same provisions applicable to the 74th Constitutional Amendment Act, but some differences. The scheduled area, the scheduled area not comes under the 5th and 6th schedule, but the 74th constitutional amendment, the scheduled area comes under the 5th schedule and not comes under the 6th schedule. But here, not comes under the 5th and 6th schedule. And next, the move on the types of urban local government. The types of urban local government, there are the 8 types of urban local government. The first one, national municipal corporation. Second one, municipality, and third one, notified area committee, and the fourth one, town area committee, fifth one, cantonment board, and sixth one, township, 7th one poor trust and the 8th one special purpose agency. The 8 types of urban local governments, the very very important one. Let us see one by one. The first one, the municipal corporations. The municipal corporation, that means larger urban areas inside the municipal corporations. Inside the municipal corporation structure is council, standing committee, commissioner. The council, the council means this councillor elected by the people, the councillor headed by the mayor. And the council is the legislative wing of the municipal corporation. They will meet, discuss, transact, that is the council or legislative wing. The council having the councillors, the councillors headed by the mayor. And the respective ward, those councillors directly elected by the people, those councillors will elect the mayor. And the second structure is standing committee. If I say the dealing with budget, I told every department have their respective standing committee. The council will come up with the scheme, how to improve the sanitation, how to get hygiene, feel we can improve the respective ward. They will have some plan. That plan only to standing committee. The standing committee will completely examine those schemes and what are the recommendations to those councils. And those standing committee, after referring those things, it will place those recommendation to the commissioner as the respective municipal corporations. The every municipal corporations have their respective commissioner, like Chennai have the respective commissioner and Delhi have their respective commissioner. And the commissioner is the topmost level. The next level, the standing committee, and below the councillor, these all are directly elected bodies. The next type is municipality. The municipality is inside the structure of council, standing committee, chief executive officer, and municipal corporations also inside the three structure: council, standing committee, and the commissioner. And the municipality, inside the structure is council, standing committee, and the last one is the chief executive officer. So the council is the legislative wing of municipality. The councillors are headed by the chairman or president. But the municipal corporations, the councillor headed by the mayor, and the municipality, the councillor headed by the chairman or the president. Okay, right. The corresponding ward, they will transfer business to standing committee. We'll examine the class by class. After the examination, this committee, it will place to the chief executive officer. And the next type, notified area committee. Somewhat the smaller than the municipality. The notified area committee, the smaller than the municipality. It will be notified. So only the name, the reason notified committee, not a committee. All the members, a notified area committee nominated. All the members, notified area committee nominated. The populations consisting of 11,000 to 25,000 people. That will comes under the notified area committee. The notified area committee, populations consisting 11,000 to 25,000 people. And the next type is town area committee. The town area committee is smaller than the notified area committee. That means the below 11,000 people. This town area committee, whether they are the nominated or elected, whether it may be nominated or may be elected, it may be. The town area committee at all are set up respective state governments. And the next one is the cantonment board. The next type is the cantonment board will comes under the exclusive under the central government. The last the four types they will be comes under the state government. The four types, that means the municipal corporation, municipality, notified area committee, town area committee, come under the state government, and the ministry and the cantonment board will comes under the under the central government. And the Ministry of Defense handling this cantonment board. The executive officers of cantonment board appointed by the president. And the military officers commanding that stations, he will be the ex officio president. That is the cantonment board. It means partly elected by, partly elected and partly nominated. The cantonment board means simply partly elected and partly nominated. The next type is township. It is the public enterprises, like the central government, public enterprises, their areas, their quarters. The township members, no elected members, all are the nominated. The cantonment board, the partly elected and partly nominated, and township members, no elected members, only the nominated. And the next type is poor trust. The poor trust consists of its created the act of parliament. This poor trust consists of both elected and nominated. It is created by the act of parliament. And the last one is the special purpose agency. The special purpose agency, up to the seven, all are the area wise. The seven all are the area wise, but this, the eighth one is the functions wise. There are the seven. One means the municipal corporation, municipality, notified area committee, town area committee, cantonment board, township, and port trust. These are the area wise. Okay. And the special purpose agencies is the function wise. It is created by the statutory body. It is not a subordinate to this local government. It is also the respective body only. It is the functions. It is the functions wise department. It is the independent one. So the special purpose agency is the functions wise department, and it is the independent one. The other seven types is the area wise, and the last one is the function wise. And the next, move on the planning committee. The two types of planning committee, one is the district planning committee, another one is the metropolitan planning committee. We all discuss about the district planning committee deals with panchayat and the metropolitan planning committee. We are discuss about the district planning committee deals with panchayat and the metro planning committee deals with municipality. Okay, there are the two planning committee, district planning committee, metropolitan planning committee. The district planning committee deals with panchayat and the metropolitan planning committee deals with municipality. We are discuss about the panchayat and municipality. In your district, there will be a panchayat and there will be a municipality. A panchayat will comes up with the some plan. The municipality will comes up with the some plan. So these plans submitted to the respective planning committee. Panchayat will submitted to the district planning committee, and the metropolitan plan will be submitted to the metropolitan planning committee. It is duty of the planning committee to consolidate both the those plans. It will person that consolidated plan to the state government. The planning committee acting as a bridge between the local government and state government. So the 73rd and 74th Constitution Amendment Act is a very, very important one. Okay, thank you. If you have any doubt, you will ask Google Class, classroom command box. Thank you.